Hi everyone, this is Aryan Mishra and this is our sixth lecture, that is Getting to Space. These lectures are organized by Spark Astronomy and Niti Aayog, where we are learning about a lot of different things, and this is our second last lecture. So today's topic is Getting to Space. In the last few topics we have talked about from basics of stargazing to how you can go to Mars and learning about galaxies, nebulas, different kinds of supercluster and everything. In this lecture, interestingly, we will talk about how to become an astronaut, right? Everybody, so whenever we look up at the sky, we are always fascinated by an astronaut, right? So if you ask a kid that, what do you want to become in life? The kid will always say that, oh, I want to become an astronaut. But what exactly does it take to become an astronaut, right? Before learning how to become an astronaut, we need to remember that we will start from a video. I'm going to show you a quick video of how you can become an astronaut and what do astronauts actually do in space. So this is the main objective. It's a very interesting lecture because it's actually a very fun lecture, to be honest. So give me, just hold on for a second. Before playing the video, I'm going to put the PPT on. So I'm going to show you guys the PPT. So this PPT, I made it. It's a very quick PPT, which is all about getting to space. So now let's do a quick run and let's study about what exactly is, you know, the space race. So the first artificial satellite was Sputnik. Sputnik was launched into the low Earth orbit on 4th October 1957, orbiting for 3 weeks before its battery died. The first satellite was launched in space. The first human-made thing which was launched in space was in 1957, 4th October, Sputnik. The first human in space was launched in 1961, after four years of the satellite launch. The first person was cosmonaut Yuri Gagarin, blasted off from Baikonur Cosmodrome in Kazakhstan to become the first human to travel in space. First woman in space. Valentina Tereshkova is the first woman to have flown in space with a solo mission on the Vostok 6 on June 16, 1963. The first man who went in space was in 1961. After 2 years, the first woman went in space. The first landing on the moon. Apollo 11 was the first space flight that first landed on the humans on the moon. It took Neil Armstrong, Buzz Aldrin, and Michael Collins to the moon. It was launched on July 16, 1969, and they landed on July 20 and came back to Earth on July 24, 1969. It was completely like a 8 days mission going to the moon and landing on the moon and coming back to the Earth. Right. So now let's see this video.
I don't know. I don't know. I can't believe we're in space.
Alex, if you look out the right side of our vehicle, you should see Australia as we approach over Australia right now. I don't know if you can see it. It might be too far. It might be over
the
horizon.
Yeah, I see it too far.
We've just made our first pass over Baikonur since launch. And we've got about 20 minutes until we're going to light off our third burn. So here should be Australia somewhere. Maybe it's under that deck of clouds over there. In any case, it's BEA beautiful. And we can definitely see the Earth is round. So particularly me as a geophysicist, I'm glad to see that. Would be a bummer if not.
The Earth is way more curved than I thought it would look from here. I mean, it is so curved. The horizon is way more than expected.
So now let's watch another video. This is, this is the same. This one. How do astronauts live in space?
And rub it in. Again, kind of working it out to the ends. And I like to take my towel while I have the shampoo in there and just kind of work it. Because without standing under running water, you kind of need to use the towel a little bit to help get some of the dirt out.
And that's it. Thank you.
That's how you get in Hickard in space. That's how you sleep in space, actually. You don't have a bed. You need to sleep
really cool
like on standing.
It. You can zip it up. We have little armholes.
What's on the menu tonight?
Strawberry shortcake.
Oh.
We've got peanut butter cookies and some strawberries with a little bit of milk on top.
And Chris, I'm going to make one for you right here.
This is strawberry milkshake.
And here's your strawberry shortcake. Ready
sorry,
for you,
strawberry shortcake.
Oh, excellent.
Thanks for the help, Chris.
Toss this.
This is kaju.
Usually, with the honey coming out pretty well there. There we go. Looks like just the right amount.
That's chapati. So just see, this is how you live actually in space. This is so fascinating, you know. This is so, so fascinating. Now look at the gym. They will take you on a tour.
Might
of the gym.
Have to use that as well. We've had to use that things. One time, which is a little bit scary inside of a spaceship using a ball peen hammer, but done a good.
Comes
let's drive backwards.
See it. Stuck. Good name.
Yeah, it was in the way.
Yes, yes. Okay. I would suggest that I open this one.
Okay.
You can please come back.
Oh, I
did so. All right. Thanks for the honor, guys. I really appreciate it. I really do.
How's she look?
Kinda cold.
That's the gym. Sunita Williams. That's how exactly you live the life of being an astronaut. This is the most fascinating things, you know, you do in space. You learn about how you become an astronaut and all the brilliant things. But one of the most important questions which always comes is that how you become an astronaut. If you remember previously in the presentation which I said, the first human to go in space was cosmonaut Yuri Gagarin. Okay, he was the first person in 1961. So now, interestingly, the most important thing is that what is a cosmonaut and what is an astronaut? You know, there are countries like China, Japan, some countries, even Iran has sent a person in space, Europe, Americans. These are the people who send humans in space. So there are a lot of African origin Americans that have gone to space. Like our own Indian origin, Kalpana Chawla has been to space. Our Rakesh Sharma has been to space. So these are something important, right? But there have been, so why do we call some people cosmonaut? Why do we call some people astronaut? People who go to space from Russia, they are known as cosmonaut. People who go to space from America, they are known as astronaut. They are the same thing, but the term is used very different. As of now, India is also planning to send humans to space in 2022 after exactly 2 years, that is Gaganyaan, what we will call to our astronauts. Now, interestingly, the government and ISRO is saying that we will not call them astronauts, we will call them Vayumanauts, Vayumanauts. Vayu ki gati mein chalna. Vayu means Vayu, Hawa. Hawa ki gati. Astronauts are basically, they are traveling in space. They are free in space, like air. That's why they are known as Vayumanaut. Vayu is a Sanskrit word. So now they will be known as Vayumanaut, this person. What is the mission? So as of now, there is not much information about who is going to space from India. But we know only certain information that the training has been started in Russia. And it will be for the first time for India to be sending a human from an Indian soil. This has never happened. Dr. Sharma went to space through, he went to space from Russia. And Kalpana Chawla went to space through NASA, that is in America. Sunita Williams went from NASA. But nobody has been launched from Indian soil. So this is interesting that this will be for the first time. And this will be also for the first time that we'll be launching an astronaut from an Indian Indian rocket. We have never launched this. So we have never done this actually. So this is something new. The reason why we need to send astronauts in space is something that we know a lot about living on Earth, but we don't know much about living in space, right? So this is important that we need to understand simultaneously and very importantly that how do astronauts live in space, right? But one of the most important questions which always comes is that how do you become an astronaut, right? Like many times I've said that how do you become an astronaut? So like I'm gonna quickly show you this is an official document from NASA. So give me 1 second. So if we go exactly to this document, you're gonna see the astronaut training and selection and training. So if you see exactly here, the history of astronaut selection is man's scope of space exploration has broadened since the first UN manned space flight in 1961. But the nation will never forget the original 7 pilots who focused our vision on the stars. So this is basically what they have been telling that, okay, the vision is this. Now, if you see this, height could be no more than 5 feet 11 inches because of the limited space available in the Mercury spacecraft capsule. Earlier when people in 1960s and 1970s, when astronauts were going in space, the height should not be above 5 feet 11 inches as the Soyuz, as the Mercury space capsule was not, cannot have a taller person like that. So this is how you become, these are the requirements, but if you come exactly here, basic qualification and requirements. The astronaut candidate selection process was developed to select highly qualified individuals from human space programs. The requirement for astronaut candidates are a bachelor's degree from an institution in engineering, biological sciences, physical sciences, or mathematics. Engineering can be mechanical, civil, electrical, any engineering. Biological sciences, you all know. Physical science, you all know, or mathematics, you all know. Sciences can be from anything, math, chemistry, bio, any sciences, right? Even a doctor can go to space. Quality of academic preparation is important. Degree must be followed by 3 years of related. Progressively responsible, professional experience, or at least 1,000, remember, most important, at least 1,000 hours of pilot in command in time in jet aircraft. This means you should be a pilot too, and you should have an experience of 1,000 hours. Are you getting it? 1,000. Either you can be an Air Force pilot, or either you can be a commercial pilot license also, no problem. An advanced degree is desirable and may be suitable for experience as follows. Master's degree, 1 year of experience. Doctoral degree, 3 years of experience. Teaching experience, including experience at K-12 levels, is considered to be qualifying experience for the astronaut candidate position. This means what they are trying to say is that you should have a bachelor's degree, master's degree, even a doctoral degree. मतलब आपको 10-15 साल की एजुकेशन आपके पास होनी चाहिए, आप पीएचडी होल्ड करने चाहिए. They are not saying that it is important, but they are saying if you have this, you will have a better chance of becoming an astronaut. Additional requirements include the ability to pass the NASA long duration space flight physical, right, which includes distant and near visual acuity must be correctable to 20/20. मतलब जो आपकी आंखें हैं, the your eye should be 20/20 each eye. Blood pressure not exceed 140/90. Blood pressure itna increase nahi hona chahiye. A candidate must have a standing height between 62 to 75 inches. Standing height should be 60 to 75 inches. Right. Now let's come to the training, selection and training part. Following the preliminary screening of applications, a week-long process of personal interviews, medical screening, and orientation are required for both civilian and military applicants under the final consideration. So this is basically that frame is trying to say that how much time they do and what are interviews, medical procedures, and all everything. Now, it takes 4 years to become an astronaut. 4 years of rigorous training. Why? Astronauts candidates are assigned to astronaut office at the Johnson Space Center in Houston, Texas. The astronaut candidates undergo training in approximately about 2 years, right? During this time, they will participate in basic astronaut training program. Basically, not only they go for a 2 years training, this is 2 years training at, so an astronaut candidate training doesn't happen only in America. It happens in Russia, it happens in Japan. It happens in Canada. You travel entire world, four countries to get an experience of being an astronaut. So astronaut candidate training program candidates are required complete military water survival before beginning their flight syllabus. Scuba qualified for them for spacewalk training. All candidates are required to pass a swimming test during their first month of training. They must have swim 3 lengths of a 25 meter pool without stopping. Matlab 25 meter ka pool aap, you should have must swim 3 lengths without stopping. Then swim 3 lengths of the pool in a flight suit, right? Tennis shoes with no time limit. They must also tread water continuously for 10 minutes wearing a flight suit. Candidates are also exposed to problems associated with the high hyperbaric and low hyperbaric atmospheric pressures in the altitude chambers and learn to deal with emergencies associated with these conditions. They're basically trying to say this, the pressure in your body and atmospheric pressure when you go up above in height should be able to deal with your body. So this is exactly what you like, you know, what you do and how you become. This is exactly, if somebody wants this document, I can send it to you. You can send me an email. And these are the some things that, astronauts who maintain flying proficiency by flying 15 per hours per month at NASA's fleet of two C2 T-38 jets. You get trained in T-38 jets. Non-pilot astronauts fly a minimum 4 hours per month. So they teach you also how to fly an aircraft if you're a non-pilot. So the people who are pilot, they get 15 hours per month and 4 hours per month for the people who don't fly. So they teach you how to fly. The astronaut training is designed to prepare personnel for space flight on the International Space Station. Abhi aapne dekha the video in which the astronauts were training, that is International Space Station. Russian Soyuz spacecraft and NASA's Aryan vehicle is future spacecraft. Russian Soyuz, if you see that videos of three astronauts sitting in a dome, that is Russian Soyuz spacecraft. NASA's Aryan is the new vehicle which will be taking humans to space. So this is exactly how you do an astronaut, how you become an astronaut. Interestingly, the most important thing is that you can be an astronaut only if you are a citizen of that country. I'm an Indian. I cannot be an astronaut in America. I need to be a citizen of America. If I'm going from Russia, then I need to be a citizen of Russia. I cannot be an astronaut to Russia. I need to be a citizen of China, Japan, or any other country to be an astronaut in their country. So this is important that everybody cannot become an astronaut unless I don't have a citizenship of that country. So this is something important and this is something easy to understand. The astronaut is a very fascinating job. You get a lot of experience because not more than 600 people have been to space in the entire history of more than like 50, 60 years, 70, 80 years. Only 600 people from the Earth, less than 600 people have gone to space. So now imagine you can be one of them. So astronaut is not an easy job. If you say somebody that I want to be an astronaut, people will be like, wow, you want to be an astronaut. If you say you want to be an engineer, it's okay. Everyone is an engineer. They're doing nothing. So in the same way, if you want to be an astronaut, like, you know, people will be like, oh, you want to be an astronaut. Why? Because it's very fascinating. It's a fascinating job, right? So this is something important to understand that astronauts are pretty, pretty fancy jobs, but requires more than 20,000 more than 20,000 people, they get selected. They apply for an astronaut application. Only not more than 15 to 18 people they get selected. So out of matlab aap 18,000 applications mein se sirf 18 log select hote hain. So aap imagine kar sakte hain kitna rigorous training hota hoga. Aur ek astronaut ban ke kaam karna, it's very important. To mere bhi kuch friends astronauts hain. Maybe jab unse when I talk to them, they tell me about their experience of space. Ek bar 4 years back, around 2016, I met Sunita Williams. So main Sunita Williams ke saath jab tha, to unse ek reporter ne sawal pucha. Main unhi ke bagal mein khada tha I was standing next to her, and the reporter asked, Captain Williams, can you tell me that how does space looks like countries, the Earth looks from space? Do you know what Captain Williams replied? She even had tears when she replied. She said that when I look Earth from the space, everyone looks equal. There is no gap in between anyone. The moment I land on Earth, I need a passport. I need a visa to travel some country, right? If I belong from a very small country, maybe a big country will never allow me to cross the border. Are you getting it? She said that there is never a difference. Like, there is no difference between any human when you look from space. So this is so important. You know, on Earth, हमारे अंदर इतनी प्रॉब्लम है कि हमारे अंदर इतना ईगो है हम लोगों में कि हम लोगों ने आपस में ही तू और मैं कर लिया है कि तू ये है तो मैं ये हूँ. बट वेन यू गो इन स्पेस एंड वेन यू लुक फ्रॉम द अर्थ, एवरीवन लुक्स इक्वल. दैट्स व्हाई इंडिया में हम कहते हैं ना, वसुधैव कुटुंबकम, एंटायर वर्ल्ड एज वन नेशन. बट क्या आज हम हैं? नहीं. यू नो, माई ट्यूशन, देयर वॉज वन ऑफ माई ट्यूशन टीचर हु ऑलवेज यूज टू टेल मी कि अपने नोट्स जो है, लाइक अपने नोट्स जो है वो बच्चों को मत दिखाओ क्योंकि वो आगे बढ़ जाएंगे, राइट? सो आई ऑलवेज यूज टू थिंक कि ऐसी थिंकिंग के साथ कि मतलब वो आगे बढ़ जाएगा कि मैं आगे बढ़ जाऊंगा, यू नो, काइंड ऑफ दिस थिंकिंग कैन नेवर लीड यू टू समथिंग. शायद आप उस समय आगे बढ़ जाओगे लेकिन ऑन अ लॉन्ग रन आप कभी आगे नहीं बढ़ पाओगे. ये मेरी गारंटी है, ये मैं बिल्कुल बैट लगा सकता हूँ इस पर. So this is something important to understand.